Hello and welcome to a very short guide to help you get the best from your INNOVV Dashcam system. So what you can do with all of those systems is update the firmware. That's the K2, the K3, the K5, the K6 and the K7. Now, firmware on modern electronic devices is really important to keep up to date with. And in INNOVV's case, they're constantly making small but significant improvements to the performance of the system you've got installed on your motorbike. So it definitely is worth the while downloading and making sure you have the latest firmware. Now, even if you have just took delivery of a brand new K5 or a new K7 and you've just got it out of the box, I would still recommend that you download from the INNOVV site the very latest firmware file for your system. Now, these firmware updates ensure smooth connectivity between your mobile phone and the bike. Sometimes they provide frame rate enhancements within different resolutions, which you'll then see within the menu system on the app. But there are lots of little tweaks that these firmware updates provide for our system, so it is worthwhile. Now, the K2, the K3, and the K6 are the simplest ones to do. And that's because on INNOVV's website, they just have one firmware file for you to choose, and you just download it and install it on your micro SD card or the memory card that you've got in your system. Now, the K5 and the K7 are slightly different, and I'm going to cover the K7 in a moment. And that's because they have two options for download. So when you get to the page for the K5 or the K7, you're going to see two files. One is called 2.4 gigahertz and the other one is called 5.8 gigahertz. So what's the difference between these two files and which one should you choose? Well, these are really about Wi-Fi protocols. In other words, the speed at which the system that you've mounted to your bike communicates to your mobile phone and your app. Now, if you've got one of the very latest phones, something that's been manufactured in the last 5 years, you've probably got 5.8 gigahertz protocol already on your phone. So that is the firmware version to download for the K5 or the K7. But if you do have an older phone that only has 2.4 gigahertz Wi-Fi protocol, then of course you need to use the older system. Now, there's not an awful lot of difference between the two. The 2.4 gigahertz is a very stable system and it's got quite a good range of connectivity in terms of physical distance from the motorbike with you with your mobile phone. Whereas the 5.8 gigahertz is much faster, so you're going to be able to download files from the system that you've mounted on your bike to your mobile phone much quicker. The thing to do is check your brand, your make and model of your mobile phone, see which Wi-Fi protocols you have enabled on your phone, and then just pick the highest rated one to match the INNOVV system. So what I'm going to do in a moment, I'm going to show you step by step with the K7. It's very similar for the K5, because there is one more step. Because there are these two files, 2.4 gigahertz and 5.8 gigahertz, one of those files is going to need renaming. The file extension name is going to need to be renamed so that you can install it on your bike. Anyway, let's have a look and I'll show you step by step. So with regards to the firmware update, it is really straightforward. INNOVV have instructions on their website, but there is one little tricky step that you just need to be careful of. So here we've landed on the INNOVV firmware update page, and we just need to find the product that we want to update, which in this case is the K7, and click on that. Now, over here on the left-hand side of the screen are the instructions of how to do the firmware update. So I suggest you have a read. Now, what they're really telling you in this section here is that the file name that we install onto the memory card needs to be named exactly this here, INNOVV-K7-1.bin. That's the file name that we need to have. But the tricky thing is, over here on the right-hand side, we've got two download options. Now, if you want the simplest, easiest way to do the firmware update, you want to click on the upper one, which is the 2.4G, because the 5.8G one, the file name, in other words, this name over here, we need to rename the file to match this, but I'll show you how to do that. But first, what we're going to do, we're going to go to the memory card, which I've installed into the computer. I'm going to right click, choose format, and we need to make sure that the file system type is FAT32, and we also need to make sure that the memory card is between 8 and 32 gigabytes in size. It doesn't work with larger cards. It will record video onto much larger cards, but for the firmware update, we need to make sure it is between 8 and 32 gigabytes. So once you've formatted the card and we're ready to go, let's go back to the website. Now, if we click on download, over here on the right-hand side, it's showing us it's downloading the file. And then when we go to the downloads folder, we can see that the firmware update has been downloaded and it has the correct file extension. In other words, the file is the right name. We've got INNOVV K7 1 bin. That is the correct name. So what we can do at this point for the 2.4 gig Wi-Fi file is right click, cut, go to our memory card, and we can paste it in there. It takes a couple of seconds and we're done. So then all we need to do now is take the memory card out of the computer, plug it into the K7 system, and everything else is automatically done. But let me show you how to do the latest Wi-Fi protocol. So we're going to delete that. We're going to go back to the website, and this time we're going to download this 5.8G file. And I'll just show you the one extra step we need to do. So we click the download button over here on the top right-hand side. We can see the file is downloading. We go back to our downloads folder where the file has been downloaded, but you'll notice that the file name is in fact incorrect. It has a number 1 in brackets. Now, if you try to install that on the K7 system, it won't recognize it. So what we actually need to do is right click, rename, and we need to delete the two bracket symbols and the number 1. We're going to delete it like so, so that the file name is now as INNOVV recommend. They're saying it needs to be called INNOVV-K7-1.bin. And if we go back, that's exactly what we've got. So we've renamed it by just removing the number 1 and the two brackets. So as before, we can right click, cut, go to our memory card and paste it in here. And then all we do, as I've just mentioned, is take the memory card out of the computer and go and put it straight directly into the K7, and then the firmware update will automatically happen. So hopefully you found this very short video useful and informative. And if you did, all I ask in exchange is you click the like button. That really helps the channel and it helps other users find this firmware update guide. Now, at the end of the video, in a moment, you're going to see a link to two videos. One is the test and review of the new K7 that I've just fitted to this motorbike, and the other one is for INNOVV's absolutely excellent third eye system, which is their version of a radar assisted blind spot detection system. Anyway, that's it for today. I'll see you soon. Thank you. Bye bye.